guys, welcome back to Charmin's Kitchen. A pleasant good night to each and every one of you. If you're visiting my channel for the first time, I would like to welcome you to my channel. Tonight, I'm gonna be sharing a recipe with you guys for a simple and delicious recipe that looks restaurant quality. And you can prepare this any night of the week. It's such an easy, delicious, mouth-watering recipe. If you want to see how I am preparing this recipe, come on down and let's get started. I will show you how you can prepare restaurant quality food in your very own kitchen. So the star for tonight is cassava cheese pie, and it's right here. So come on down, guys, and let's get cooking. So for the cassava cheese pie that I will be making today, I have my cassava peeled and washed. I'm gonna start boiling it until it's nice and soft. In the pot with some boiling water, I added the cassava pieces with a half a teaspoon of salt. I'm gonna cook the cassava until they're nice and soft, like when you're making potato salad. Cassava also goes by the name yuca. To go with our cassava cheese pie, I'm gonna be making some baked kingfish in the oven, and I'm adding just a few simple ingredients because this fish is delicious and it takes no time at all to cook. So first of all, we're gonna go in with some salt. Enough for taste. And I'm gonna leave all the measurement that I used today in the description below. I'm gonna be adding some black pepper. And just a little bit of key ingredients. I'm gonna be adding some green seasoning, and this contains of garlic, thyme, green onion, and pepper. That's enough. And I'm gonna be adding some smoked paprika for color, a little bit of heat, and it's also gonna have a nice look when it's finished. So I'm gonna be adding into the paprika some extra virgin olive oil to that. It's gonna help the paprika to stick to the fish, and it will also help the fish not to stick to the bottom of the pan, and we're gonna have a clean finish when it's done. So we're gonna pour this goodness on top of the fish. It's gonna have that really nice color that we want for a finish. And then I'm gonna go in with my hands and gently mix all these ingredients in. I will show you how it looks once I finish marinating the fish. So I finished seasoning the fish and they already look beautiful. I'm gonna cook them in my 350 degree oven for about 20 to 25 minutes until done. So we're gonna check on this, and I can see this is done. They're breaking up and falling apart and nice and soft, and that's what we're looking for. So I have the hot cassava here, and when I drain it, I leave a little bit of the water in that it was cooking in. Because cassava, when you drain it out, it tends to get very dry. But we want this to be a very moist and nice cassava pie. So what I'm doing here now is I'm gonna break the cassava up into small pieces. Just like when we're making potato salad. So now that I finish cutting up the cassava pieces to smaller bites, we're gonna add some flavor now. And I'm gonna be adding a little pinch of all-purpose seasoning. You can add any seasoning of your choice. I will add some dried parsley. This is gonna give some flavor and give a nice look when we're finished. I'm gonna add some green seasoning. Not a lot, about 2 teaspoons of green seasoning. Just the flavor of the cassava. And because I added salt in the water when I was boiling the cassava, I wouldn't be adding any salt at this moment. Because we're adding cheese as well, and the cheese will be on the saltier side. So now we mix all that goodness. And while it's still hot, I'm gonna add some cheese. So first of all, we're gonna go in with 1 cup. And I'm using the triple shredded cheddar cheese. We're gonna mix that in. And we're gonna add another cup into here. We want it to be cheesy. We're gonna mix that second cup of cheese into the cassava. And it is looking good, but I wanna see some more cheese in there. So I'm gonna add a third cup of cheese, and we can still add more if we like, but we're just gonna eyeball it. So we're gonna add about 1/2 cup more of cheese. So that's 3.5 cups to 2 pounds of cassava. And you know what? It's just about 1 cup of cheese we have left in the bag. So I'm gonna use the 1 cup. So that's 4 cups of cheese. The cheesier, the merrier. And we're gonna mix the cheese in before we add the milk, because the milk is cold. And once we add the milk, it's gonna stop that cheese from melting. Wow, this looks good. And now we're gonna add our milk. Just about 1/2 cup of milk, because it's already on that nice soft side. And we're gonna put this in our baking dish to cook in a 350 degree oven until our cheese is completely melted. So now we're gonna add all that goodness to our baking dish. Wow, this is like a juicy version of macaroni and cheese. We're gonna spread this out. And what we're gonna do now, we're gonna sprinkle some of that parsley on top. That's gonna make it even prettier. And then we're gonna add some more cheese on top. And we're gonna put this baby in the oven. And then just a few minutes, it will be ready to go with our fish. So in the pan here, I'm gonna be preparing some spinach to go with our dinner tonight. Just a little bit of olive oil. And I'm gonna add 1 big bundle of spinach into the pan, just like that. I wash the spinach and I chop them up roughly. I'm just gonna add it. And this will all boil down to a very small amount. I'm gonna add a little pinch of salt on the spinach. A little bit goes a long way. Just a sprinkle. And we will mix this spinach up. So now we're gonna mix in that salt. And this spinach takes just under 5 minutes to prepare, and it's really, really delicious as any side. So right in the pan, I'm going to be grating a nice large clove of garlic, and this will really, really enhance the flavor of the spinach. So we're going to mix up all this garlic now. So the spinach is done perfectly the way I like it. So here it is, our Friday night dinner. Some delicious sauteed spinach in garlic and olive oil. I cooked some kingfish in the oven, nice and delicious looking. And we made our beautiful, yummy looking cassava cheese pie. So right after this, I'm gonna show a success story for Sister Donna, who followed my recipe for kalaloo or bhaji rice, and she was happy with the results. So she did the whole works with it, the kalaloo rice, she did ripe plantain and fried fish and all the good stuff. So I'm gonna show those clips right after this. So come on down and let us check it out. So here's that beautiful Friday night dinner. This is our cassava cheese pie. And if you never had this before, you would certainly love to give it a try. It is so delicious, so cheesy. And this is the star for tonight. I'm gonna dig right in for it. Cheers, guys. My goodness. I feel like a kid tonight. It is so delicious, nice and creamy, and so cheesy. It's so satisfying. Every day we should have an intake of some good vegetable. So I'm gonna have some of that garlic spinach with some of the cassava cheese pie. It's too good to be true. My mouth is having a very big party in there. So now we're gonna take a bite of the kingfish. And tonight I baked the fish. It is looking so scrumptious, and I'm a big fan of fish. So I'm gonna take a nice piece, and so flaky this fish is. Some of that gravy here. Oh my god, so delicious, so juicy, so flaky, and the flavor is just like eating salmon. So in my plate here have a beautiful party, a beautiful combination going on. I wish you guys can taste what I'm tasting. If you can taste through the phone, amazing. So I want to say, if you like this recipe, please give me a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel and you haven't subscribed, I hope you will consider subscribing. Until then, stay blessed, stay safe. Love you guys. Bye for now.